Yeah, and that reminds me very much, and I'm very passionate about it. So it's almost when you do something which you're really good at, it's almost like you're working with effortless ease. So instead of investing a shitload of energy into the process gives you energy. And that reminds me of being a bobslayer, because even though it was hard work, I was doing it with almost effortless ease. I know you can relate to that.
I can definitely relate to that.
Yeah.
I was wondering when your project of going to the Olympics, it didn't end up with you going to the Olympics, and I think you tried for the next Olympics, and then how did that all end, and how did you experience that whole transition out of sports?
It ended up the way actually I qualified for the Olympics twice together with the first time it was in the two-man bobsleigh, and the next time it was in the four-man, in the big four-man bobsleigh, and I'm extremely proud of that within 8 years we actually managed to qualify in every other country in the world, maybe not Holland, but in the Netherlands, maybe in every other country in the world, we would have been sent as proud ambassadors for our country. But coming from Denmark, at that time at least, things did not work that way. At that time, you were only picked for the Olympics if you could prove that you had a medal chance. And we were only 20th in the world, and we could not prove by being 20th in the world, which in fact is a great result, being 20th in the world, we could not prove that it would be possible for us to go to either Salt Lake or Turin and be in the top 10 or make a medal. 3 months are, when we stopped the concept in February 2006, I was so tired. I was so tired that I could have slept for 3 months, and I could and I was struggling with telling. I was struggling with telling the story of the 8 years. At that time, I couldn't. I could up until the day we didn't were picked for the Olympics. I could tell the story. The day after we were not picked and then we stopped the concert, I could not tell the story anymore. It was just too painful. I think it was 3 or maybe it was 4 months later, the Danish National Olympic Committee decided to change the rules for the future so that if you have the international qualification criteria, you would be sent. So with the rules today, I would have gone to the Olympics twice in my life. And I'm not saying that it was due to our project that these rules were changed, but I'm pretty sure that there was somebody in the Danish Olympic Committee having the feeling that it cannot be that we have probably maybe the one of the best stories in many years we can tell, and together with the other Winter Olympians, that they didn't have the rule set to send us, and they have changed that now. So in generations after us, if you are qualified for the Olympics and internationally, you are going to the Olympics. And I know even if our contribution was just a tiny little one, I'm very proud of that contribution.
Yeah.